discussion is Keynesian theory of demand pull inflation. As according to Keynes, aggregate demand is the main source of, which is the source of demand pull inflation. Aggregate demand is the source of demand pull inflation. Then what are the sources of this demand? So demand may arise due to consumption purposes. Demand may arise for investment in business. Businessmen may demand for investment in their inputs. And demand can also arise due to government's demand for more goods and services to meet its civil and military requirements. So government may demand more goods so that it can meet the requirements, military requirements, civil requirements of country. So from here we can say that aggregate demand is having three elements, that is consumption, investment and government expenditure. And when at full employment level this aggregate demand is more than aggregate supply, then there arises the inflationary gap. And this inflationary gap is the main reason for demand pull inflation, main reason for Keynesian inflation, as Keynes has also explained in his theory. Then larger this gap, there will be rapid inflation. There will be more inflation. And if APS, that is average propensity to save, if it is constant, then rising money income will reflect only in the excess demand at full employment level. And when there is excess demand, there will be again inflationary gap and there will be inflation, more inflation in the economy. Now Keynesian, this analysis is basically short-run analysis, having the assumptions that prices are fixed and output is determined by changes in the investment spending levels, right? Now Keynes has linked all his analysis with that when there is increase in the quantity of money, there will be fall in the rate of interest, as both are having the inverse relation. And rate of interest is having inverse relation with investment also. So when rate of interest will fall, investment will increase, right? And here multiplier will start working. With increase in investment, there will be increase in income levels, and with that finally there will be increase in the aggregate demand. Now if at that level, when there is increase in aggregate demand, there are unemployed resources, so it will affect only output, not the prices. If at that level, when aggregate demand increases due to these reasons, resources are unemployed, then it will affect only and only output, not the prices, right? But suddenly, when there is large increase in aggregate demand, and at that point supply of some factors might be inelastic or short supply, in that case there will be increase in marginal cost and ultimately there will be increase in the price level. Now price level will rise when price level will rise above the average unit cost, and there will be increase in the profit level also. And at that time the trade unions will demand more wages. They will pressurize managements to increase their wages, and there will be hike in wage level also. So some industries diminishing returns will set, but once there is full employment, once full employment is reached, at that level elasticity of supply of output will fall to zero and price level will increase now without increasing the level of output. At that time when folks were unemployed, there was increase only in output but no increase in prices. Here when full employment level has been reached, there is only increase in price level but without increase in the output levels. Now any further increase in expenditure would increase only increase the demand. There will be excess demand and ultimately there will be increase in prices, right? So here in this diagram also, IS and LM curves are used to show this analysis. Here at the intersection point of IS and LM curve, at E point there is R zero rate of interest and Y is the income level. This is the full employment income level at which R zero is the rate of interest. When there is increase in government expenditure, IS will shift rightwards to become IS one. There is new level of equilibrium and new rate of interest R1 and new income level Y1. Now corresponding to this E point, AD is the initial aggregate demand and P0 is the price level while there is a full employment level of income. When there is increase in government expansion and IS shifts to rightwards, there is also increase in aggregate demand in the economy and AD shifts to AD1. Now at E to E1 is the excess demand in the economy which is beyond the full employment level. With this, there will be increase in the price level P1. But with this high price, there will be fall in the real money supply. And with the fall in real money supply, LM will shift leftwards. Leftwards, and again full employment level will be, full employment equilibrium will be restored. So full employment equilibrium will be restored, but at higher rate of interest and higher price level in the economy. So that means Keynes is explaining that so long as there is unemployment in the economy, changes in the income will be reflected in the changes in output. But once there is full employment in the economy, all the things will reflect in prices only, and there will be rise in prices only, there will be the inflation. Right?